Good day. I'm Janet Robinson, Superintendent of Schools, Stratford School District. I'm here today to introduce to you our new strategic plan. It's a five-year plan. Stakeholders came together, and over 100 people in Stratford, parents, community members, kids, some of our students, teachers, we all sat down together over a long period of time to develop a new mission statement, with some strategies to implement that mission statement, and people have really worked hard to come up with action plans to see that all of this comes to fruition. We're very excited as it's going to guide the work for the next 5 years in Stratford. I'd first like to introduce to you the mission. This mission guides us. It lets us know what our true north is so that we can make our decisions based upon what is in the advancement of our mission. The mission of the Stratford community is to ensure that all students acquire the knowledge, character, and 21st century skills to succeed through high quality learning experiences and community partnerships within a culture of diversity and respect. This is already starting to be implemented with the hard work of some of our planning teams that have been working on enhancing the strategies. After this mission statement was developed, we set out to really look at what are the strategies we would have to achieve in order to make the mission statement a living, breathing document for the Stratford School community. The first strategy was to strengthen family and community partnerships. You're going to hear more about this as we begin our discussion of these action teams. This is really an important one. It really encompasses the culture that is Stratford, with these partnerships with our community partners. The second one was implement mastery-based learning. Some of you may be hearing about that already as we are starting to look at how we go about setting up mastery-based learning. This is going to prepare our students for the kind of future that they have. The third one is integrate 21st century skills. These two, the mastery-based learning and the 21st century skills, are really integrated. Even though we had two action teams, they've been working together to really make sure that whatever we do in the way of mastery-based learning also prepares our students for the 21st century. And finally, to implement a social-emotional learning curriculum. That doesn't mean we didn't have this already. We've had many things going on in each of our schools. But what we're doing is we're trying to make sure there's a continuum. So as students go through elementary, middle, and high school, there is some cohesion about what they are learning in the way of social emotional learning. And you're going to hear more from that action team too. And this is a really important aspect of our plan. We know from the research that unless kids are really ready to learn, then they don't acquire the academic skills. They're not as successful as we would like our students to be. Now I'd like to introduce to you Tammy Trojanowski, who is going to talk a little bit about the family community partnerships, and I think you'll be very pleased with the hard work that's gone into each of these strategies.
Hi, I'm Tammy Trojanowski with the Town of Stratford Community Services, and I worked with Katie Graff, assistant principal at Bunnell High School. Our team was focused on strengthening family and community partnerships to ensure that every student has access to real-world learning and career opportunities. We had a dynamic team of 30 parents, community leaders, and school faculty members, and we had some very robust discussions that led us to three themes. One, meet students and families where they are. Two, provide meaningful ways for students to engage in authentic learning. And three, provide high quality instruction for real world learning. From our discussions, we developed 10 action plans. These include an online location to find community and business resources, reduce barriers to family engagement, welcoming schools that are inclusive of all families, family resource centers, cultural competency training, business partnerships, connect teachers to their counterparts in industry, partnerships with colleges and technical schools, curriculum that connects classroom instruction to real world, and school improvement teams. The last four words I'd like to leave you with are inclusion, equity, empowerment, and access. That's our vision, and we know that we'll get there as we continue to work with our community, school, and family partners to benefit our students.
My name is Andrea Fonseca, and I am a reading consultant at Second Hill Lane School. I had the pleasure of working with Samantha Pugh, the department head at Stratford High School, in co-chairing this committee. Our committee comprised of 20 members, including administrators, teachers, parents, and students. We focused on the second strategy for the district, implementing mastery-based learning, including high-quality instructional strategies, and engaging content that reflects the diversity of all students. Mastery-based learning is an instructional practice and philosophy that provides students with the opportunity to learn at their own challenging pace. It's based on the belief that all students can learn at high levels. In mastery-based learning, students are given multiple opportunities to develop their understanding, as well as multiple opportunities and ways to demonstrate their learning. Our committee developed 9 action plans in order to implement mastery-based learning throughout the district. Essentially, they include providing opportunities for students, teachers, and parents to fully understand all aspects of mastery-based learning, developing instructional methods that align throughout the district to support all learners in order to ensure that every student has the most challenging opportunities, and finally, updating the way we assess and report students' accomplishments, including appropriate work habit expectations, content, and skill mastery. Ultimately, this strategy will continuously provide support necessary to push all learners to the next level.
Hi, my name is Diana DeCenzo, and I'm a 5th grade teacher at Eli Whitney Elementary School, and this is Jason Cream. He is a science teacher at Worcester Middle School. Together, we were co-chairpersons for the 21st Century Action Team. Our team comprised several members that included administrators, teachers, and students. The strategy we worked on was to integrate 21st century skills into all classrooms, supported by a comprehensive assessment system. Our group focused on additional areas that went beyond academics that we felt that our students need to be successful in the 21st century. We researched other states and districts to determine 5 key areas of focus for our students. The 5 key areas of focus that we developed for our students include: students should be effective communicators, critical thinkers, and problem solvers. Students should be creative and innovative, good citizens, and lifelong learners. After we defined these areas, we developed 8 action plans, and Jason now is going to provide a summary of those plans that we worked on.
The team created plans to integrate new grading guidelines based off of our 5 key areas of 21st century skills. The plans include providing support for teachers, students, parents, and administrators through training and communications. One goal is for our students to have a choice in how they will demonstrate their 21st century skills. Finally, we will revise report cards to communicate student progress in 21st century learning along with mastery-based learning. We are proud of the work that our 15-member team has accomplished, and we're excited to implement the plans to help students be successful 21st century learners.
My name is Lauren Cavalli. I'm a 4th grade teacher at Lordship Elementary School, and together with Marina Ciccarini, who's a social worker at Worcester Middle School, we co-chaired a team of various teachers, school support staff, administrators, parents, community members, and students. Our team worked hard to plan a way to implement a rigorous social-emotional curriculum that promotes character development, social-emotional wellness, and positive behaviors. We looked at 8 different actions that we would need to take place in order to reach our goal and to effectively teach the whole child. Beyond content, skills, and application, we need our students to be at their best in order to do their best. So we really broke our actions up into 2 different areas: exactly what is it we wanted to teach, and how are we going to make sure that we reach all of our students. So one of the actions we wanted to say what we're going to teach is to look at a district-wide social-emotional learning curriculum. With that, we also want to make sure that we're effectively training everyone in that curriculum. We want to make sure that teachers and students are using the same expectations, using the same ways to assess, and using the same language. How we make sure we're going to reach all of our students is we're going to do several different things. One action we really want to make sure that took place is that we established school-based medical, dental, and mental health clinics in all of our schools. We talked a long time about developing welcoming school environments for all of our Stratford families. We wanted to make after-school activities and summer activities accessible to all students. The more positive experiences they have, the more positively developed our students are. And lastly, in order to make sure we're addressing the whole child, we really need to make sure our students are in school, so we felt it was important that we planned a district-wide attendance policy. When all of these strategies are fully implemented and our plan is on its way, we will graduate all of our students in the healthiest way possible.
Hello, my name is Linda Gaeta, and I'm the Assistant Superintendent for Stratford Public Schools. As you've heard from those who have gone before me, there's been a great deal of work done by many individuals in our district and in our community to help develop this five-year blueprint for our work going forward. You might be surprised to know that prior to this new strategic plan, we've been working over the last few years and have accomplished a great deal of work that is connected to the four strategies that you've heard about this evening. For example, strengthening our family and community partnerships will require a great emphasis on communication. This year, our new website was unveiled. It has a Google Translator, and we're working at making communicating through our website an easier, more user-friendly type of process. We work very hard on strengthening the climate. Each school has its own climate plan. Our district has a climate plan, and we meet regularly to talk about how well we're doing on improving the climate in our districts and in our school. Mastery-based learning and 21st century skills. There's been a great deal of curriculum work that's been done, curriculum and instruction, as well as assessment. During the professional learning community or PLC days, teachers get together to talk about their new curriculum as well as ways to assess student understanding about their information that they're learning in class as well as the 21st century skills that they're developing. Our programs and resources that have been adopted over the last several years are programs and resources that promote differentiation in the classroom so students can be working at their own level and the level that is best for them. For social-emotional learning, there's been a great deal of training in the district on responsive classroom, restorative practice, developmental assets, and trauma-informed classrooms. We will continue our efforts to identify a curriculum for students in K through 12 that will help to develop better social-emotional skills for improved positive performance and behavior. So please watch for updates and look for opportunities to engage in the discussion and give your input. If you have any questions, contact your child's teacher or my office and the contact information on the last slide. Thank you very much for your time.